ampere battery, this is 2 ohms, this is 2 ohms, 1 ohm, 4 ohm and 4 ohm. Okay? This is A, this is B, this is C. Why I am naming all of this? Because I want you, all of you, to follow the same naming convention. That's why. And also for the current, let us use the similar notation. For example, suppose from here current I1 comes. Okay? Current, you can start from anywhere. You can say, okay, current starts from here. Okay? As long as you are following junction rule, it doesn't matter. Fine? So current starts from here, and let us say I2 goes there. How much current will go there? I1 minus I2. Fine. Now this current I2 goes like that. Then if I2 goes like this, and suppose this is current I3, what will be this current? I2 minus I3. Okay, what about this current? How much this will be? This is I2 minus I3, this current. Then? I2 minus minus I1. Okay, now check here, is junction rule satisfied in this junction? Current coming in is what? I2 minus I3 minus I1, and I1 current coming from here. So this is I2 minus I3 here, and from here how much current is coming in? I3. So is it satisfying? Are you sure?
Yeah.
I1 minus I2 comes like this. So this is minus I3 coming like that, and plus I3 goes like this. So net net becomes 0. Okay? So junction rule is satisfied. Now you have to find out I1, I2 and I3. Okay? Now, how many loops you see here? First tell me that. There are more than 4 actually. But then if you see that, all the loops are made up of these 3 loops. Two or more of these 3 loops, all the loops are made up of. Okay? So we'll just write down equation for these 3 loops, because if you take other than these 3 loops, once you write these 3 and you take other loop other than these 3, that equation will be redundant equation, will be sum of the 2 equations. Okay? So first step is to write down equation for loop 1, loop 2 and loop 3, and then solve those equations to get the value of I1, I2 and I3. Yeah, sorry for that. This is 10 volt. You just have to follow whatever direction you take, follow junction rule. Okay? If your junction rule is satisfied, you can assume any direction. Fine? And if that direction is not correct, the final answer you may get it as negative.
But the direction has to be same for all of them.
What do you mean by that?
Like 1, 2, and 3
have 3
anti-clockwise.
As in? No. That's not necessary. It just, I'm denoting here so that I can tell you that I'm moving like this. You can as well move like that. So you are anyway equating to 0. Multiply with minus 1. Direction changes. It doesn't matter which direction you travel the loop. It doesn't matter. Just neatly write down 3 equations. Okay, very very neatly. Loop number 1. Okay, in a nice handwriting. First expression. Then for loop number 2 and loop number 3. Okay. Have you done this? Should I write? Just write down the equation for now. Because if you get a wrong answer, then you know that your equations are wrong, it will be not so nice to get. I am anyway writing down, then you can. You can write down what you understand better. Okay, let us start. Loop number 1. Should I start from C? I'll start from C and end at C. Okay? So what should I write? Here, what should I write? Across one of from where 10 comes? I am traveling here. No. Minus I1. Okay? Minus I1, then what? I am going from negative potential to? Because I am traveling along the direction of current and through the resistance. This is surprising. Potential will drop, no? Potential will be decreasing. So change in potential is negative. So minus I1, then what? Here. I am jumping this cell. What should I write there? Plus or minus 10?
Plus 10.
I1 plus 10. Then what? I am going above. What should I write?
Minus 4 I2.
Then what?
Minus 2 I2 minus I3.
I have reached point number C, so this should be equal to 0. How many of you got this correct first attempt? Okay, good to.
Sir, I took it completely as 1 over. That's why I got 10 minus I1, sir.
Oh, okay. So you took it like an internal
issue? Yeah.
Okay, loop number 2. This is loop number 2. What should I write? I'll again start from C only. What should I write? Minus 2 into minus I3 minus I1. Fine. Then what should I write? What? Point C. What should I write? I'm coming here now. What should I write here? What?
Plus.
I am going again the direction of assumed direction of current. So plus 4 times I1 minus I2. Then what? I am going like this. What should I write? Minus 10. Then what?
Plus I1.
Plus 1 into I1. So this is I1 equals to 0. Okay? Now loop number 3. I again start from C only. What should I write? I am going like this, starting from C. What should I write? Plus 2 into? Then?
Minus 5.
I am going from positive terminal to negative terminal. Then what should I write? Plus 2 into?
I2 minus I3 minus I1.
This is equal to 0. Okay? So these are the three equations in front of you. Now what happens is that many a time student doesn't have practice of solving, you know, these type of equations. So lot of error happens. So right now these are the three equations in front of you. All of you please solve these three to get I1, I2 and I3. Okay?
Sir,
so,
what?
Sir, so, would it be
minus 5
I? Minus 5? This battery, there is no resistance. This one? Because I am going from C upwards. I am going like this, isn't it? So C say I am going to B. So I am going against the direction of I2 minus I3. Any other doubt?
Anything, how the point after C is I2 minus I3 minus I1.
See, I2 minus I3 is coming like this, and this is I1. So this become I2 minus I3 minus I1. Okay. But ultimately, you may find I1 more than I2 minus I3. That is fine. But all you have to do is to make sure junction rule is followed. Okay? Now solve these three equations and get the answer. Let us see if all of you get the same answer. It had never happened past 6-7 years that all the students got the same answer. This is a challenge for you guys. all of you try to solve this equation and get the same correct answer. Or the probability of getting same wrong answer is almost zero because there are so many wrong answers. Okay, so we have the first answer. Tell me.
I by 4.
5 by 2. 5 by 2.
How many
is 5 by 2? 5 by 4. Now you change your answer, 5 by 2. Just check. I1, let me verify. Yes, 5 by 2.
I2 is 5 by
8. Yes.
I2 is 5 by 8.
See, it works. If I shout at you, you start getting answers. So I should do that quite often. So I should find reasons to shout. Okay, we'll do one more question. Similar. So that you understand properly. Any one of you did not understand the previous one? You got the answer? Mr. You got it? 5 by 2. Do this question. Brothers, all of you should get the answer. There is 100 ohm, 10 ohm, 60 ohm, and 5 ohm. This is 15 ohm. Similar notation, let's assume some current here. Let us say this is I. Okay, this is I, and if I say that this is I1, how much is the current here? I minus I1. Fine, then this I minus I1 reaches there, and I say I2 goes there. How much is here?
I
minus I2. Right, so how much is current in this branch? Can you find out? This one is what?
I minus I2.
Right? You can use junction rule. I1 coming from here and I minus I1 minus I2 coming here. So amount of current coming in should be equal to amount of current going out. Now check whether this is I or not. It is I. So everywhere junction rule is followed. Okay, how many loops you see here?
2 3 4. Actually the whole loop can also be,
there can be 5 or 6.
Yeah.
Okay, but then if you see the elementary loops are 3.
Yeah.
One is this, other is that, and this one. So I just name them so that we all follow the same thing. You write down the Kirchhoff's loop rule equation for 1, 2 and 3. Just write down the equation and we'll see after. So very neatly write down the equation for loop 1, loop 2 and loop 3. Should we write now? What?
3 is like this. This
3 is this smaller one. I am taking only elementary loops. Yeah. I am not combining any loops. Yeah. How many equations you need, by the way? How many variables you have? I1 and I2?
Yeah.
You need 3 equations. You just need to write 3 Kirchhoff's. Okay, let us do this. Let's start from A, from bottom. What should I write? Tell me.
60 I1
plus 60 I1
minus
100 I minus I1 minus 15 into I minus going like this along the direction of current. You did not write it.
No, I will look plus.
Then you negative of that equation. Equation will be same. Let's see about the second loop. I will again start from A only. What will I write? 15 of I minus I1 minus I2. Then minus 10 I2 plus 5 I minus I2 equals to 0. Let's write for the third loop. I'll start from again A only. Let's start from
minus
A. Minus 5 into I minus I2, then plus 10 minus 60 into I1. This is equal to 0. Fine. All of you got this equation?
Yes, sir.
Now solve it.
So from A, what direction are you going in the third loop?
I'm going like this.
So minus 5 into I minus 5.
I'm going against the up. In the direction of current, I'm going.
Yeah. So you're going to 5 into I minus 5. In the
direction. Minus. Along the direction of current, if you write it, it will be minus. For resistance.
15 ohms is coming down in the direction of current, no, the center.
Yes.
Yeah, there will be minus.
Yeah, we wrote it positive.
Which one? Okay. Yeah, for loop number 1 it is correct. You are going in the direction of current. But for loop number 2, you are going like this. Okay? Solve it to get the answer.